So there's not one thing that causes autism, and we aren't going to find one thing that causes autism. There are multiple things that interact, complex gene interactions with the environment that make someone present with characteristics we call autism. So some studies have found an association between autism and acetaminophen, but those studies haven't been well controlled. And so what that means is those things go together, maybe because moms who have a fever or migraine or infection during pregnancy are more likely to take acetaminophen. But we don't know that acetaminophen causes autism. And when we look at well-controlled studies that look at genetics and environmental factors, that association goes away. Use of acetaminophen has remained flat or gone down for women during pregnancy in the past couple of decades. So it would be very hard to explain an increase in autism when we have seen flat or even less use of acetaminophen during pregnancy. So as far as the science would say, if you are pregnant, then acetaminophen is likely a very safe alternative, probably the safest for pain and fever. Of course, I would recommend talking with your doctor about your specific situation, but it is safe as far as the science is concerned. We have really good scientific data to show that fever can increase likelihood of developmental conditions during pregnancy and other things like pain as well. So it's important to control those in safe ways, like with acetaminophen. There have been a couple of very small studies looking at folinic acid in autism. The largest one only had 80 individuals, and there's a very small signal for some improvements in communication in some kids. And so it's possibly promising for addressing one of the difficulties of autism, which could be communication, but we really need large controlled clinical trials before recommending that anyone actually give this to their child.